Boris Johnson drank a can of peach juice from Fukushima to prove the product from an area in Japan which has suffered a triple nuclear meltdown is safe. The foreign secretary is filmed saying very good and yum as he happily slurps from the can. He smiles at the camera and says mmmmm as laughs are heard in the background. Japanese Minister for Foreign Affairs Taro Kono brought the can with him on his visit to London this week, The Telegraph reports. He tweeted the footage of Boris taking gulps of the drink with the caption, British FM Boris Johnson drinking peach juice from Fukushima, showing the products from Fukushima are safe. The foreign secretary made the show of support as he praised Japan as Britain's strongest Asian ally in a diplomatic love-in. He met his Japanese counterpart Taro Kono accompanied by Tory Defence Secretary Gavin Williamson at the National Maritime Museum in Greenwich, London yesterday. The ministers agreed to give extra British counter-terror support ahead of the 2020 Tokyo Olympics, including a possible joint exercise of security forces. Mr. Williamson praised the meeting for cementing a historic relationship between our two great island nations. But the charm offensive risked being derailed by Brexit as Mr. Kono warned Japanese firms' fears must be smoothed over. Mr. Kono also demanded an agreement on how goods and services are traded between the two countries compared to the EU, known as mutual recognition of standards. Mr. Kono said, "I hope the process will be predictable and transparent for the Japanese companies. Before the Brexit is realized, I know there are some issues that the UK must take care of. One is the mutual recognition of standards and also agreement on judicial support. We have an agreement with the EU about those, but with the coming Brexit I want to start preparing to make such agreements between Japan and the UK." Mr. Johnson insisted mutual recognition can be readily and speedily accomplished. Meanwhile, Mr. Johnson, who said he saw eye to eye with Japan, said the two nations will together pile pressure on China to cut off its lifeline to North Korea. Mr. Kono warned North Korea's missiles could hit Europe and the nuclear state's arsenal is the most urgent and important threat faced by the international community. Mr. Kono told a joint press conference in London, "We will never accept a nuclear-armed North Korea." He added, "The ICBM-class ballistic missile of North Korea is reaching not only Japan or South Korea, but also includes a range reaching Europe or the United States' west coast. So that is a threat to the international community." North Korea prompted international outrage by flying a missile over Hokkaido in September.